Welcome to the side.
I think when people look at our family, they see this perfect family.
I think we've painted almost this facade of this perfect, loving family, and we are that loving family. But underneath that, there's something much deeper and hidden, and that's found in our genes.
All day long, I stare at data, CAG over and over and over again. Just sounds like a string of letters, but when you put it together, we're looking at a disease.
My Aunt Diane started showing some of these symptoms. She was shaky and she would get in car accidents all the time, and we just initially thought, oh, she's just the worst driver. My mom got a phone call from Diane's husband that said, whatever this Huntington's chorea is, that's what Diane has. And that was the first time we had ever heard of Huntington's disease.
So Huntington's disease has three major symptoms, motor symptoms, cognitive deficits, and behavioral symptoms. They present in different ways in different people, but over time they become more pronounced, and over 15 to 20 years, they become quite severe, and then people eventually suffered early death as a result.
Currently, there is no cure. You have treatments that manage the symptoms, but you're just slowing it down, but not really.
It affects the whole family, because by the time people may become aware they have Huntington's, they've already had children.
When you research Huntington's, you see the 50-50, and it's genetic. That opened up a whole question of who else in the family is at risk, and the answer was everyone.
Becky and I were just like, it just, you know, it can't be Jenne. Because when it's Jenne, then it's more than Jenne.
I have two children, and the statistics are that one of them will carry the HD gene, that I would have passed this on to one of them.
What I want to do is just do something good in my life and just leave, it sounds so cliche, but like leave the world a little bit better than how I found it. I was very fortunate to be in a position where I am able to do what I not only want to do, but love to do and am good at doing, and also be in a position where what I do every day actually contributes to helping people and to making a difference. Every day for the past 6 months, my team and I have been screening the entire genome to try to find a future drug target. We know exactly what causes Huntington's disease, but yet it is so difficult to target because there are other genes that also have CAG repeats. You know exactly what you should be doing, but you just don't know how to do it. Even though I'm in the early stages of my career, I've spent the whole time fixated, I guess, on how to solve this problem. What I'm going to do about Huntington's disease.
I always knew I wanted to have children and a big family.
Jenne wanted 3 to 5 kids. I was totally fine with 3 kids. 5 was pushing it.
When Luke was born, and I remember the first time they handed him to me, I knew that that was what I was meant to do, was to be a mom.
We were really looking forward to having that third child, and possibly 4, maybe 5 if Jenne got her way, until we got the news.
I just remember turning to Blake and just saying, it's gonna be okay, but knowing in my heart that it wasn't.
Witnessing Jenne die of the disease and possibly my children before me is something that I can't deal with. I don't think anybody signs up for this.
I think about Huntington's disease every day.
What color eyes does mommy have, Emma?
No peeking.
Pink.
Symptoms could onset and progress any single second.
My aunt started developing symptoms of Huntington's when she was in her late 30s, early 40s. I have 3 or 4 more years left.
When, you know, you can just look at your cells and you can just look at the spreadsheet, there is a barrier between you and the people that you're doing this for. I've never met anybody with Huntington's disease. I don't have a face.
What are you drawing, Emma?
Logan?
What I want to do when I meet Logan is give her the biggest hug and let her know how much of a difference she is making. Because the work that she's doing is what gives me hope. And hope is everything. I've been telling my kids that they get to meet a superhero today. So they're dying to
meet you. I would have worn my cape if I knew.
Not all superheroes wear capes.
Just seeing her face for the first time and knowing that she's looking at me with hope, and I'm saying, I don't have anything for you yet, but I'm trying really, really hard. I'm gonna get there for you, for the kids.
All right, scrub those sugar bugs. Scrubbies. One of the things I've learned about drug discovery is that it doesn't happen overnight. There are so many pieces that have to come together to bring a drug to market.
Elizabeth was a beautiful princess.
I'm so thankful to every single person that touches any piece of that process. It may feel like it's not making a difference, but it is. We're so inspired and grateful for the progress that's being made, but the clock is still ticking. I think about how many more years I have until this disease will take over my family.
We think about it every day. We think about, is this the day, every day.
If something doesn't change in the world of science, I kind of know the way the people I love the most die.
Something's gonna happen to him. You know, this is like a train coming at you. And the question is how you can get out of the way and how you can get involved in getting out of the way.
The questions that I think about are, is this experiment going to work? And even if it does work, am I even gonna get meaningful results? Can we even make a drug for this? When are we going to be able to help these people? What's at stake in the story is families, entire lineages.
It's about letting us live.
The good news is there's things on the horizon.
I see a cure for Huntington's disease in this lifetime, and I think we're very close. When I look at my cells, I'm going to see Jenne. And when I look at the data, I'm going to see her kids. It's a race against time.
We need this to happen soon, or we lose this race.
I research.
All of our hope lies with the people who are working on this cure.
I search.
Meanwhile, we are waiting.
I race.